It's Mutant Bobblehead Day for the first 10,000 fans with extra limbs here at 3 Mile Island Stadium here in Steeltown, Pennsylvania.
I got 7 extra knuckles, Grim.
Hey, extra fingers and toes don't count.
Today's matchup promises severed limbs and ruined careers and lots of beers. The Motor City Maniacs battle the Blitzburg Steelheads. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. It's a beautiful day for MFL football, at least in the booth with the AC, personal servants, and blood shield. Hi, Grim Blitzrow here with you, along with my partner Brickhead Mulligan and Mini Bricks. How are you guys doing?
I'm doing that little hottie who works the deep fry at the concessions.
He said how, not who, you idiot. Even if you got the answer right.
And it's first and 10. 4 yards on that one. And he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
Second down and 6. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 on that play. And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. And it's 1st and 10. And they run it for a couple of yards. And that'll be 2nd and 8 to go. Oh, that was a hit. You ever had your lights knocked out like that, Bricks?
I'll take the salad, Steve. Wait, where am I?
And they'll line up for the punt here. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. Nice catch, and he turned. Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. A lot of guys talk about stepping up their game, Bricks. He just stepped. The coach isn't liking that call. Oh, his head just exploded. And this is a first and they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. First down and 1 mile. And they went to the air and came up big. Second down and more than the QB would like. Third down and long.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's first and 10. In the locker room by his team after the game. Second down and 10. And he was running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe two.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Except the zombies. They are freaks.
Third down and 8. First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot eight.
And he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day, because he's the one who just got wiped out.
Hot one, hot two, hot,
and he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done. A 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
Straight through the uprights. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
Second down in a very lot. And he just wrestles away from that set. That's a nice gain of about 7 yards on that run. Third down, and the punter is warming up. Quarterback just threw a sonic blast to his receiver. And he finds open spaces running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
It's anyone's game at the end of quarter one. And it's first and 10. Was an all-pro MFL hit. Second and three. Third down and nine. Remember, folks, in the MFL, you are allowed to touch the quarterback just like that. And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. The cross-stitching, unbelievable.
They just let that one drop and played safe, and the defense says, we'll take it. And it's first and ten. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're going to hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor.
Finish him.
And it's first and ten. Pick up 7 yards on that play. Second and three. Like he just ran into the line at the DMV.
And guess what, Grim? That line ain't moving.
Yeah, that was kind of my point, Bricks. Third and two. Freight train. Nice pickup there for a first down. And it's first and ten. And the defense was ready for that bombs away dirty trick that time. Second down and ten.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
And that'll bring up third and one. The offense is pretty much unstoppable. Oh, with the punishing hit. And it's first and ten. For a first down. And it's first and ten. This is your brain, and this is your brain on berserker drugs.
And that is that guy's brain getting crushed out of his helmet.
Oh, man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. As they say at the deli, who's next?
Can I get a Swiss on rye with the... No mustard.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
And it's first and ten. Looks like the defense, you know what they say, oh, and he fumbles the ball on that hit. When you hurl and get hit, chances for a fumble increase. chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't abroad in my bed. It was a chip wearing a wig.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
The kicker died on that play.
That's terrible. Now what do they do?
Well, another player will assume the kicking role for the remainder of the game. The coach is praying he won't need a long field goal to win this one. And it's first and 10. Give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of...
The offense calls a timeout. This is why you save your timeouts. You can use them in the two-minute warning.
Now I get it. Makes sense, Grim.
The quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense. He's looking for a quick score.
Aren't we all, Grim? Aren't we all?
When the defense calls thunderclap, the offense is toast.
Oh, did he ever get zapped? Reminds me, you ever hear that Zappa song, Watch Out Where the Huskies Go? Don't you eat that yellow snow? When I was a kid, I always ate the yellow snow. They were like lemon snow cones. But them fudge ice cream sandwiches, they didn't taste so good.
First down! I've seen this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bop.
They've got one more timeout left, but they've stopped the clock.
Why don't they just take the batteries out of the clock, Grim? That would make more sense.
The quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense. And he held on to that one for a first down. First down and 3. And they take their last time out.
It's between them and the clock now, Grim.
Well, and the defense, too. The offense goes into their two-minute drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing as a hurry-up offense.
Oh, big catch, big run, big touchdown.
Yeah, big deal. Mr. Beeper Brain ran with a ball and didn't fall down.
Hey, man, nobody can touch you with an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about, pal?
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They just be...
The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and 10. Nice run for 5 yards. They stump the clock with their first timeout, leaving them with 2 in case they need them.
Yeah, just like condoms, hatchets, and wives, huh, Grim?
You know, you just summed up why we don't get together outside of work, Bricks.
That's a 4-yard gain. The quarterback is controlling the clock right now like the clock is into it.
He just clock blocked the clock.
Third down and a sliver. And that's a run for no gain.
Then it's not really a run, is it?
And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered Frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. We're back for the second half as the teams line up for the kickoff. The coach told his players they'll be strung up on the goalposts if they don't make this a game in the second half.
That's how you motivate these pricks.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner.
Something went very wrong with that box away.
What was your first hit? The lack of blood? Everyone having all their limbs? He's an idiot.
Third down and never gonna happen. He rifled that one in there and they come up with 10 yards on the play. Comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. And he's got a chance for a good return here. Pow! With the brain scrambler. And it's first and 10. Ground game is starting to soften up the defense. First down. And it's first and 10. Kaboom! And the quarterback unleashes a sonic blast against the defense. Oh, nice hit. First down and 7. And like a monkey truck. And he picks up maybe 4 on that play. Second and 3. And he zips that one in there for a touchdown. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. Oh, that was a big... Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after 3, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
And it's first and 10. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. Oh, with the brain scrambler. And it's first and 10. When defensive players go berserk, they've been known to rip the heads off of enemy players. Second down and long. Footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
And the defense gives up 5 yards there. You know, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. Misfired punt will give the opposing team great field position. The return man catches the ball and heads upfield. Oh, with the brutal hit. And it's first and 10. Man, he shoveled his feet so well on that play. He should go to lost wages and deal cards. First down! And it's first and 10. I'm not sure who he was throwing to on that play. Second down and 10. Running like a moose right now. Third down and, well, good luck.
That was a nice piece of running, Grim. That's a first down.
And it's first and 10. Catch on the play.
Every little bit counts. Those 3 yarders might grow up to be somebody one day.
Second down and 7. Third down and 9. Just got crushed. Quarter three comes to an end, but this game is far from over and will be decided in the final quarter. And it's first and 10. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It's good. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. It's first and 10.
Hit that line the way a Republican congressman hits the airport men's room. Good and hard. First down.
And it's first and 10. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. He did it. He scores. And with that amazing run, he bursts through the end zone for 6. Now this should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. Right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? And it's first and 10. Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a convalescent home.
Second down and more than the QB would like. And that player just transformed into a giant. Good luck blocking this guy. And there aren't many things better than a running back blasting through the defense for a big gain.
Except pizza.
Yeah, I'm sure you got pizza.
And burritos.
Okay, you make a good point.
Oh, and pickles. Gotta have pickles.
He might have managed to dig out a yard on that one.
Not my yard. Got too much buried in, you know, the usual money, bodies, coffee cans filled with, well, you know, mostly coffee. Tastes better, like Eskimos burying salmon heads, kimchi. Fermented anything really tastes good.
And he put all of his foot into that one. And he snags the punt and looks for open field.
And a dog thing snags.
Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And it's first and 10. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're gonna hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor.
Finish him.
And it's first and 10. And that'll be a first down. You know, Bricks, a lot of people have gotten pass happy in this league. Nice to see some old school mano a mano on the turf, huh? And it's first and 10. Knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
And it's first and 10. He's got his beast boost working. The player just transformed into a violent form of pure badass. Oh, the defense must have called a hot potato dirty trick. That'll wake you up, and then put you to sleep permanently.
You snooze, you lose.
Unless you're in a sleeping contest.
And it's first and 10. QB passes it for maybe a yard. They've got to open up the offense here, Bricks. Second down and 9. the fourth quarter, and we're at the two-minute warning.
2 minutes until what?
Third down, and the offense needs a miracle. First down! He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. Either the defense is trying to keep some time on the clock for their offense, or someone let a real bonehead touch the controller. And it's first and 10. A nice run there for 8 yards. At this point, they're going to have to get the ball back by any means necessary, or wasting 2 timeouts on the defense is really going to bite them in the ass. And he rumbles into the end zone for the score.
I hope he's not going to dance now.
And they line up for the extra point. Straight through the uprights. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. First and 10.
Call me turkeys on Thanksgiving.
Oh, that's a big time hit. You ever been hit like that before, Bricks?
Have you seen my beer?
The quarterback burns his last time out. They can't stop the clock anymore. Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a 2-minute drill. Threads the needle for a first down. And it's first and 10. And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was off to the races. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The onside kick's the desperation play, but it's their only chance at this point to steal a possession.
Stealing ain't right, Grim. It just ain't right.
Stack the line, and he gets his bell rung for a yard. And it's first and 10. Call man about a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation. The way a rolled up dollar bill.
The Blitzburg Steelheads win this one. The entire game was trench warfare. Both teams battling back and forth, bruised and battered, but in the end, there could be only one winner.
There are winners in my book. I think that a defeated team should get a participation award because, yeah, I tried really hard.
Why don't you try real hard and shut the fuck up?
Nice. nice mouth. Why don't you try to lay off the scotch, Junior?
Suck on it.
Real nice. Let's go to the game's MVP. With Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by ComCrack Entertainment. They're not happy until you're not happy.